Hi, this is Gary with MacMOST.com. Let me show you how to use Spotlight Actions. So a new feature in macOS Tahoe 26 is called Spotlight Actions. And the idea is that instead of just searching for something, you can actually perform some actions using apps on your Mac. You could do some of this before, but now it has its own section and it's pretty well defined. So let me show you how it works. To bring up Spotlight, you can click the Spotlight icon in the menu bar or use Command Space. To get to the Actions section, you can move your pointer and you'll see four different sections of Spotlight. The third one is Actions, and you can use Command 3 to get there as well. Then it lists some of the actions you can perform. There's a long list here, and what you see is going to depend on which apps you have installed, although a lot of these are for the built-in apps in macOS. A simple example would be this one, random number. Let's double click it, and you'll see that it's not just going to perform an action, it's going to first prompt you for input. In this case, a minimum number and a maximum number. I'll type 1 for the first parameter, tab, and then type 10 for the second, and then return to execute the action. And I get a random number. As a neat bonus, it stays there, and I can press return again to run it again. So I can just keep generating random numbers like that. I can press escape to escape out of it and get back to actions and escape again to go back to the regular Spotlight search. If you find these videos valuable, consider joining the more than 2,000 others that support MacMost at Patreon. You get exclusive content, course discounts, and more. You can read about it at macmost.com/Patreon. Here's another example. Instead of scrolling through the list, I'm just going to start searching for it. I want to do something in messages. And if I just type message there, I'll see some results. And one of those is send message, which is exactly what I want to do. So I'll press return, and now I can type a message and a recipient. So I'll type hi, tab over here, and then type a recipient. If it doesn't know who I mean, it'll give me a list, and I'll just choose the first one. You can use the arrow keys to select if you want. I'll press return, and it will send that message. It never even launched the Messages app. But if I look at the Messages app now, I'll see that it indeed did send the message. Now, let's say you use one of these often. You could assign a quick key to it so you can get to it even easier with more accuracy. So we've got that message one. And we could see here that next to each one of these, it says add quick keys. Notice how since we've used send message, it assigned SM, taking the first letter of each word here, as a quick key. So now we can use SM instead of searching for send message. We could also click in here and define our own. So let's say we want to use MM instead, because maybe we use SM for something else. So I'll use that. Now I can go to Spotlight, and just with regular Spotlight if I want, or I can go first to the action section, I can type MM and then return and get to this useful functionality. There are plenty of other actions you can take that are built in. Most of these are for specific apps, so they're listed by app, and you'll see different things here depending upon your apps. For instance, I've got Excel and Word installed, and there's a couple of things they provide, but things with notes, you should see the same things that I do as well. There's also a lot under Other. These are mostly things that are provided by the Shortcuts app. But in addition to this, you can create your own shortcuts, and we'll take a look at that in a minute. So look through these and see which ones may be useful to you and try them out. For instance, here's one called Create Note, and allows you to quickly create a note and put it in whatever folder you want. I'll just have it in the main folder there. And you can see it opens up the note and there's the new note with the name I assigned to it as the title there. If I search for mail, I'll find that there's send email, and I can send a message with a subject to recipients right here in Spotlight. Some of the actions are context sensitive. So here is a file I've selected in a Finder window. Now, if I bring up Spotlight, go to Actions here, and search for Move, I'll find an action called Move File. I'll press Return to use that, and it will recognize that my current selection there is that file. You can see it named right here. I could press return to accept that, but now it needs a destination. I'll start typing the name of a folder and it will give me some results there. I'll type return to accept the first result and it will run and perform that action. And it shows me the result here, which in this case is just the image that was moved. So now I can look here in this demo folder, and you can see it did in fact move, or actually duplicate and move that file. Another context sensitive one would be the count action. I can select a bunch of files here. I can go to Spotlight Actions, search for count, and then press return. It'll show me 7 items are selected, which is a bit of a spoiler, but you can see it says count items in current selection, and I can press return and it gives me 7. But here, if I'd got text selected in text edit and I use count, it's going to take the selected text as the input. And I can actually do shift and tab to go backward here to that items parameter. And let's go down to words and put words and then return for selected text. And now you can see it tells me there are 9 words selected. So the same action, count, can count files, you can count words and other things. And here's one more example. I've selected 4 images here, and I'll go to Spotlight Actions, and I'll search for combine, and there's combine images. I'll press return, and you can see there are 4 images. I'll press return to accept those 4 images, but now I'm going to tab over to where it says horizontally, press delete to clear that, and now you can see I actually have 3 options there, horizontally, vertically, or in a grid. I'll press return for in a grid, and it'll return those 4 items now combined in a grid. I can drag this out as a file like that, or press just return again, and it's actually going to open up the combined image now in preview as a new document. Now, all the existing quick actions are great, but the real power here is that you can create your own, and you use the Shortcuts app to do that. So as a simple example, I've created a shortcut called Synonym. And I've said in the details here that it's to show in Spotlight and receive input from Spotlight. So now it's going to receive input, and I've set it to only text. And you see it says search result, which is what you get when you check this. And then it's going to use a new action in macOS Tahoe called use model. So it's going to use an AI model with a prompt. And it's this prompt right here, pretty basic, just asking it to give me a list of synonyms. But at the point of the prompt where I have the word or phrase, I actually take the shortcut input and put that in there. And then I can set it to Apple Intelligence, which is using Apple servers, on device only, which is using Apple Intelligence, but just on my Mac. So it's not calling out to the internet. I could actually even be offline or call out to ChatGPT. So this is a handy little shortcut that'll give you a synonym without having to go to the thesaurus. And it might give you different words and maybe more words because it's using AI instead of a hard-coded list in the dictionary. Now, the name of this is Synonym, and since I've selected Show in Spotlight and receive input from Spotlight, I can see it when I go to Actions here and I start searching for it. So it comes up right there. I can even assign a quick key to it. Let's do that. I'll just use SY for this. So now, in Spotlight search, I can type SY and I can press return since it's the first item selected there. And now I can type my input and then return, and it will execute that prompt. What's even better is you could type the quick keys space and then the word, and you could see now pressing return will automatically take what's after the space as the input. So I can get the result in even fewer steps. And this is a really simple example, just to return some text from some text. But you could build shortcuts to take all sorts of actions and do all sorts of different things, and then access them through Spotlight Actions. There are also a few other things that appear in the Actions menu that are context sensitive. One is you can get menu items. So when I go to Actions here and I search for something that happens to be in a menu in the menu bar, like bold, I actually will get it as a result and can activate that item from Spotlight. So it's handy to find menu items that might be deeply down in a submenu. Like, let's look for strike through, and you can see it comes up there, return, and it executes that menu item. So that could come in handy. Another thing you'll get, but it's kind of inconsistent, is if you search for the name of a window inside the app you're using, like in this case, there's a window called blank.pages, you'll see it as a result here. And you can use this to jump to that window. So it could be useful if you have a ton of windows open. So there's a look at using the new Spotlight actions on your Mac. Take a look at what's available there to see what could be useful to you, and consider creating some of your own actions using shortcuts as well. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.